Hello, hello! Welcome to Ivana's Norsk Life. I know I promised you a next video about taxes in Norway, but it is quite a complicated topic and I want to make sure that all information is correct. So I need a bit more time to finish my video for that topic. But today also I want to talk about something that I went through not so long time ago, and it is buying a new house. What it means in Norway, what are the steps that you need to go through to buy a house. So let's start the vlog. Buying a house or an apartment in Norway, it is sometimes can be very challenging, especially if you do it for the first time. If you don't own any house or apartment in Norway and you just want to do it for the first time, there are some critical things that the bank will be asking you. First of all, that you have a secure job with a good payment. It should be 5 times more than your spending covering like on expenses for the loan on the house or apartment. Then the next one, it is that you need to have 15% of saved 15% from the total cost of the house, total price for the house. You need to have it saved on your bank account. If you don't have these two things, most likely you shouldn't start contacting banks, because if you are not Norwegian, it is high chance that you will be rejected. I'm sorry to tell you that, but it is true. But let's imagine that, okay, what if you have this 15% saved and you have a good job? What should you do? I recommend you to contact as many banks as possible. And this is what we did in June. I applied for a documentation that is called Finansieringsbevis, financial statement that you need to get from the bank before you actually can go and buy a house. So it's kind of saying that you have a bank that is ready to give you a loan for this amount of money, and then when you go hunting for the houses, you will need this document with you, and you cannot go outside of the limit that is provided for you by bank. So it can be a huge probability that some of the banks, or maybe many banks, will reject, but it's enough to get one bank to agree to give you a loan, and you can use this information to negotiate with other banks as well. So this is like, remember, even if you got a rejection, but some bank has provided you and said, okay, we agree with this and these terms, before saying yes to them, take this offer and go to another bank. Maybe that was preferable for you. You wanted to work with them and say, okay, I have this offer. Would you be interested to having me or no? So in my case, what we did when we were applying for Finansieringsbevis, we also got rejections from some of the banks, but then we got one bank that actually agreed, and we used offer from them to negotiate a better offer from our bank where we originally had loan for our previous house. So this is also a good thing to do. And remember that in Norway, you can move your loan after your house loan afterwards to any bank who will be willing to give you better conditions. So it doesn't mean that you will be staying or with all with this the same conditions with the same bank for many years. When you're buying a house, you can actually also select a loan period. Typically, it can be different, but it can be 30 years, 25 years, and depends also on how much you have or can afford yourself to pay monthly. So after you got this Finansieringsbevis, the next steps that you are going, into fin.no webpage and start searching for the area and houses that is in the price range that you can afford. Don't forget that when you're searching for the house or an apartment, you need to search a bit below the limit that is given to you, because especially on the hot seasons for buying a house, it is somewhere about August, September, October in fall period, and then it is about March, February, March in the spring period. Rest of the time, the competition is much less, but COVID of course also made its own rules used and people started behaving slightly differently, but still it also works now. So you need to remember that during these high seasons could be like more than one couple or one person wanted to buy a house, and then it means that you will actually be participating in the auction. So you will go on showing of the house, you will look at it, and for instance you liked it. After the day when you had the showing, you will also know there is a day until which you can place your offer. So you are filling in the official form, and then it's done everything digitally, and then you send it in. Typically it is before the noon next day after showing. So if it's more than one person who wants to buy, they kind of give a counter proposal, counter offer with raising money. And then from this moment there is a rule of 30 minutes where you start kind of like playing with each other. So it's an auction, who is gonna win. So you need to remember that if you're buying a house in this hot season, then it means that it can go really up, like above the price that is listed, even 500,000 Norwegian kroners. So if the house is good, if the neighborhood is good, if more than one person wants to buy it, really wants to buy it, then be careful. There is like many different ways of how you can play this game, but still it's one thing. And the another thing that of course you can try to go after a house that stays longer market, that had more than one showing and no one is buying. So then you can try to go in and give a smaller offer. It also can work like that, especially for the houses that stay very long on market. But then the question is that you need to remember to ask yourself, is everything okay with that house? You need to check a technical report about the house that is provided in Norway. And now a new regulation, it's a tech report where you can see on which level there is level 0, 1, 2, 3. 3 it means that it's an urgent require urgent change. 2, it is kind of that it's worn out some stuff, but it will require in the future change. And 1, it's typically green, and 0, it's when it's only just built a house. So then all of these things you check in the report, and then you can understand how good or what are the problems with the house, can you deal with them, can you afford yourself to deal with them, and so on. So usually when these hot seasons, you have much more choice and much more competition, but on these really not high seasons, low seasons, you will have much less choice and of course less competition. So it's up to you to select which strategy works for you and which budget do you have. Also remember that house, it is an investment. Yes, sometimes it will require some expenses, but still remember that it is investment. And in Norway, that's why many people actually own their properties, because then you still pay rent to the bank, but it's not that far away from paying the rent to someone else when you rent in an apartment. So that's why in the long run, if you plan to own a house for 5 years, it is a great investment, but also it comes with a lot of responsibilities. Good luck on your trip with buying a house if you plan to do that, and see you next time. Bye.